Alright, so let's do a gender bender review. This time it's Just Charlie. It was produced in 2017 and it was directed by Rebekah Fortune. It was written by Peter Machen and it stars Harry Gilby as Charlie Lindsay, a transgender girl. Quite promising at soccer, actually. And the movie starts with Charlie, still presenting as male then, playing soccer and being recruited by a team, you know, a professional team, youth development thing. I think Charlie's like 14 or so. And Charlie's father is very proud of him. And yeah, Charlie, you have a chance that I didn't have. He's very, you know, I didn't have this chance, you have to take it and so. And Charlie's like a bit reluctant, but Sean still likes playing soccer very much. We then cut to Charlie's sister throwing away some clothes, and Charlie going into her room and saying that he's going to throw her clothes away. But the thing is that Charlie takes her clothes and hides them because so he can try them on himself later. And we then cut to a bit of dysphoria. Charlie holds a bra above the chest and feels like, why don't I have breasts, you know? I mean, I wear a bra, but, you know, feeling like that, but things are flat and so. And feeling very, why, it's not right. And we then cut to Charlie playing some soccer, but just feigning an injury because he isn't really sure if he wants to play any soccer anymore. And we then see the family go to the church, and Charlie just hides out and goes to the forest place where he's hidden the clothes and starts trying them on and wears some makeup and so. And Charlie's soccer trainer spots Charlie and doesn't confront it, just observes and then silently walks off. And then we see Charlie again in the soccer bus, and the coach talks to him and says that there are more important things in life than soccer. And he then also mentions that he saw Charlie in the forest. And Charlie urges the trainer not to say anything to anyone, because Charlie's very afraid of the parents finding out or anything. We then cut to Charlie's sister going away with her boyfriend, and then Charlie's parents also leaving to go to a dinner or some event, and Charlie being alone in the apartment or house. And Charlie starts wearing makeup and dressing in female clothes and so. And it's in a very happy place, and then it's just abruptly cut because Charlie's father discovers Charlie in the makeup and so, and, "Oi, what the fuck are you doing, mate?" or something like that. And, "Wipe that shit off your face." And is very upset and angry about Charlie wearing makeup. And Charlie just, no, and starts feeling very sad and sorry about everything. And it's just, the mother comes in and it's just such a turbulent time. And the parents mention, "Why have your grades slipped?" And Charlie says, "It's because I feel so unhappy and so sad about, you know, all this." The whole trans thing isn't mentioned explicitly here, but it kind of sneaks up on you, really. I mean, you understand that Charlie's trans, of course, but we really don't talk about that. And the father is just, "Why? Why would you want to live a life where things are difficult? And why would you want to throw away your chances when you can play soccer and become famous and rich and all that? I mean, I've worked in a factory my whole fucking life and I hate it." But Charlie doesn't feel like that. And we then gradually cut to Charlie opening up more and more. The father is very, very opposed to everything. Very, for a very long time. Sean's best friend Tommy is also quite upset about it. And confronts Charlie and Charlie's sister Eve. And calls Charlie a fucking tranny or freak or anything in, you know, that regard. The way people address trans people when you want to be derogatory. And Charlie's sister intervenes and Tommy pushes her to the ground and Charlie retaliates by giving him a punch to the face. And we then see Tommy's parents confronting Charlie's father about it. And it's just a big argument because Charlie's father is so unsure about how he should react because he's upset with Charlie as well. And now he's just giving shit for Charlie being who Charlie is. And Charlie shows up at school wearing a dress and is, you know, ignored by almost everyone and humiliated in some ways by her peers, and she's very upset about that. But on a positive note, the trainer has found a team for Charlie where she can play, a girls' team. And most of the girls accept Charlie. I mean, she gets to play a game and so. But then some of the other girls think it's not fair that Charlie's playing with them because she's biologically a boy. And Charlie's forbidden to participate, and the girls are, you know, on two sides here. But then further on, the suspension is dropped and Charlie is allowed to play again with the girls. And from there we go on a very happy note for quite a while. Charlie opens up, she comes to terms with Tommy and they become friends again. She finds a friend, a girl friend, not a girlfriend, but, you know, a female friend that she hangs out with, and things seem to be going generally well. And the father is also, you know, becoming more and more accepting, even though he doesn't say anything because he's already left because he couldn't stand Charlie presenting as female and so. But then the father, you know, he does something positive. He buys a pair of pink soccer shoes for Charlie. And he goes home to see Charlie, but Charlie isn't there because Charlie's out with her friend at a Tivoli or some, you know, gathering for youths and so, with her female friend then. And they encounter some boys, and the female friend takes an interest in one of them. And they have a bit to drink. Charlie ignores drinking. And the girl and her partner slides off, and the guys, two other friends, they start embracing Charlie, and they find out that Charlie's biologically male, and they start beating the shit out of Charlie. And then the original boy and also shows up and starts beating the shit out of Charlie. And the girl, the female friend, then just runs away to find help and runs into Charlie's parents, and they just come to defend Charlie, and then cut to black, and the next shot is at the cemetery. We see Charlie's father sitting there, seeming very depressed and melancholic about things and so. But they are trying to fake you out here, but Charlie has died, but she hasn't, because it's the wedding of the daughter. And we're introduced to the wedding of the daughter, and Charlie is the maid of honor. She's walking behind her sister, smiling, beautiful blue dress, very beautiful makeup, great brown hair, and looking as if she's on top of the world. And she then sits down with her parents, and they both, you know, embrace her a bit, and it just ends on a very happy note. So that is the plot of Just Charlie, and yeah, it's pretty cliche if you think about things. I mean, We have conflict with parents, wanting to try on female clothes, getting beaten the shit up, as is always the case in movies with transgender themes for whatever reasons. We have Strella, Boy Meets Girl. The Crying Game, Boys Don't Cry, etc, etc. I mean, it's always, you know, the transgender reveal panic, trans panic as it's called, and how people freak the heck out about that. And I think that it's really been beaten to death, the whole trans panic theme now. As a girl like me, when I wrote your story, also as this. And I mean, I think most people understand what trans panic is nowadays. You don't have to force it into every single transgender-themed movie. I mean, it's the same with parents. I mean, pretty much every... or in acceptance, I mean, pretty much every single transgender movie has this. Oh, I don't accept you for who you are. In this movie, it's Charlie's father and Charlie's grandmother. He refuses to see Charlie and the family because of this. And I don't know, I mean, why do you have to have the same storyline in all movies? I mean, the Danish girl also has this about, you know, people not accepting and beating the shit out of someone. And sure, I mean, it's great to raise the transgender theme. And, you know, topic, not theme, but topic, but I think it's pretty much everyone knows what transgender, being transgender is nowadays. Not everyone, but most people do, and I don't think showing movies where people beat the shit out of trans people in every single movie is something that you really need to do anymore. There haven't been any new trans movies this year, but there was Girl, but it was just about a very dysphoric teenager and her struggles. But she was pretty much accepted, and I hope that we are moving in that direction, that we address the dysphoria itself and not people's issues with gender dysphoria. Because we're not going to progress any further with that. Yes, people are idiots, people can be ignorant, that's it. But the main issue here is you and your body, and not feeling like you belong in your body when you're transgender. I mean, I felt that very much when I grew up. I mean, I hated when my voice changed. I hated growing hairs on my everywhere, on my in my pubic area, in my armpits, on my stomach, on my arms, on my legs. And especially facial hair, I was so sad about the whole thing. I mean, I tried to cut off my skin just to not have any hair here. And it was so very depressing. And Charlie here, she's still in puberty and she gets help with puberty blockers. And I think that it's important for, you know, family members to realize if your child is feeling terrible and is hating going through puberty, it might be more than just issues about growing up. It might be about issues about growing up to be someone you, who you are not. And intervention here is very essential to helping children out. I mean, I am so disappointed in my parents and the healthcare system that they can't help me out. Before I'd went through puberty and my parents still not being very accepting even after that. And the healthcare just ignoring everything and my life going where it is with depression and everything. And I think that movies like Just Charlie, they show that you need to be there for your children and you need to support them. Sure, it can be hard, it can be very, very hard. I mean, but the thing is, even if you don't understand it, it doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. It can still be very, very real, but it's not something that you will understand or so, but you can at least try to accept it, because it's for your child's own good, for their own mental and physical health. I mean, there is a reason why suicide is so high among transgender people, and it's because they are just so depressed about both their bodies and their environment, and everything just not matching up how they feel what things should be. And they're not getting help from anywhere. I mean, the healthcare system in Sweden is actually very trans-inclusive, but we still have a waiting line for over 2 years, and that's not okay. But that's just how it is, and we need to do something about this. We need to be better at helping transgender children and transgender adults, just and transgender individuals in general. The same for every LGBTQ person. We need to help them and make them feel included and not excluded from society. And I think just Charlie does a good job of this, and I remember when I first watched it, and it was still when I was living as presenting as male. It was in December, so pretty much just before I kicked off this YouTube channel or this series that have been going on for half a year. And I remember just feeling inspired, and I can do this, and I've seen many transgender movies, and this is one of the better ones. There are flaws, of course. As I said, there are many clichés, but it feels very genuine. I know that Just Johnny is based on a short by the same writer and starring some of the same characters. I think that the sister was playing Charlie in the first concept video of this. I think it was made like 2010-2011. And then it got made into another one, and this one is very good, and I definitely recommend you checking it out. And I'm giving it an approval rating. Yes, I'm giving it an 8 out of 10 or so. And yeah, just watch it. So that's it.